In our national lead, President Trump claims the steel industry is thriving thanks to him. Yet today we are learning U.S. Steel is temporarily laying off about 200 workers in Michigan. And the president's tariffs may be partially to blame. If the economy is the defining issue of the 2020 election, CNN's Martin Savage found there's a divide emerging in the Rust Belt over whether the Trump economy is working for everyone.
Scranton, Pennsylvania, home to the sitcom The Office, ta-da, the birthplace of Joe Biden, in a state where white working class voters helped propel Donald Trump to victory. And if he hopes to win again, Trump's chances may hinge on those same voters and the economy. So I'm here asking people, how is the economy? And I'm getting two very different answers.
Yeah, I think things are definitely good. There's more jobs in the area. The stock market's really high.
I think we're on the verge of a recession.
I quickly pick up on a theme.
How are you feeling about the economy?
I'm feeling optimistic.
So if I asked you, how's the economy, you say...
have some concerns.
How people view the economy here is directly related to how they see the president. Jessica Stotzman owns Diskin Saloon, and she's a huge Trump fan.
Did you like the fact he was a businessman?
Yes. Yeah. Yes, that was one of the biggest things. I feel the country has become like a business.
Criminal defense attorney Paul Walker is definitely not for Trump, and he sees trouble ahead.
And if this economy turns like I think it's going to, then it's going to turn on him.
Scranton's a factory town. Nationally, manufacturing jobs numbers are the highest they've been in a decade, according to the Department of Labor. But there are signs hiring and production are slowing. Bad news for manufacturing workers, a key part of the president's base. People like Trump voter Douglas Waltrip, an electrician. Economic forecasts suggest dark clouds, but he sees only sunshine where he works.
We got more work than we know what to do with right now.
Really?
Yes.
I ask another key question. Would voters stick with the president if the economy turns negative? Union rep Joe Labaranti, a Democrat who voted for Hillary Clinton, doesn't think so.
We're on a high right now, and if we go belly up, I think it's going to be a big, big difference.
While Trump voters say even if the economy turns bad, they would still back the president.
Right now, yes.
Would you vote different?
Not necessarily, because I think the economy is always up and down.
And there was another question that I decided to ask these Trump voters especially, and that was, are there any Democrats out there they might consider? Every one of them said no. I said, what about hometown Joe Biden? Even Joe Biden wasn't very much appreciated here. Erica?
All right, Martin Savage. Appreciate it. Thank you.